gay, but all of this is just implied. There is very, very little that is stated directly in this movie. Believe it or not, what's not stated directly, who the killer is. At the end of the picture, we don't know for sure. Whoever he is...
El Azteca completamente.
So-and-so truck driver today ran over his baby son's head and it burst like a watermelon. And then they said it's 22 degrees out. So I figured on all of those days.
Psychosemantic police, you can't even see us. How in the fuck can you do anything about it? We're pure intelligence.
Yeah, thanks for picking me up again. I'm looking forward to, I'm looking forward to driving stick because my mom had a stick shift like all throughout like my life.
Oh, really?
And still? Yeah. She doesn't have it anymore.
Oh, you got a little hat?
This is my driving hat.
Yeah. Oh, okay. These are my sunglasses that I wear.
Yeah, I wear this hat.
But, like, I wear it when I mean business.
I wear this when I drive.
Okay, well.
We're rehearsing for this play. It's about these two Norwegian clam fishermen. Anyways, we're practicing in, like, this studio. It's, like, a small little place. It's not even, like, a stage or anything like that. But Rose works there.
Uh-huh.
Our screenwriting
teacher.
Oh,
Rose, Rose Nogberg.
So yeah. I was texting her a little bit about the play and stuff. We had like a rehearsal on a Tuesday night and I accidentally left my jacket there. Mm-hmm. And like, I don't know, I didn't want to lose this. I've had it for a while. I like the way it looks and stuff. And the next night I wasn't able to make it to the rehearsal. And
she texts me at like midnight and she's like, the studio just burnt down.
No.
And I was like, oh fuck, is my jacket okay?
You ever seen those videos of people who take out the pump and they start spraying people?
No.
Like gasoline. Funny. It's funny, but it's kind of fucked up. It's like kind of like watching somebody get attacked, you know?
Like, did you hear about that thing in Russia?
Like, okay, I woke up this morning and it was like one of the first things I thought of. And like, I was still kind of like sleepy, so maybe yeah. It's like half like a dream type of thing.
If we had like a really bad war and we had to get drafted, it made me think of like why all the other wars sucked. Like it doesn't really affect your life, and now you have to like go over there and like die or something.
Yeah. Ever since I knew I wanted to like like make shorts and movies and like mm-hmm. try to do music and stuff, and like what more people think about. Like imagine like going back in like in history class. Like yeah, this soldier brought like some cameras with him into the war, and he was trying to make a movie as he was like fighting the front line.
We could do that now though.
Yeah, you could do that now with, like, phones and shit.
With, like, digital stuff.
A lot of people say it would just be nukes and shit. Like, there wouldn't be, like, really like, any battles. I feel like it's not gonna be, like, any other war. Like, I don't think it's gonna be as close range as World War II. Just because, like, the weapons they had back then. Mm-hmm. Like, weapons they have now are pretty insane. You know, there's no bayonets and shit anymore.
How the fuck would they get us to Russia?
I don't know. That's pretty damn cold over there.
Yeah, that would suck.
Yeah, I wouldn't want to fuck with the Russians.
Oh, bro! There was a bottle in here!
A what?
There was a bottle in here. You could have pissed in this instead.
Oh. Nah, that's good.
I gotta be in the moment. Stop looking.
Where's the pee? Where's the pee? I gotta move.
We still need to like schedule the shooting and all
that.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, that sounds good. And then eventually Smodders and Rotten Pavement.
Rotten Pavement, yeah.
Ah.
I mean I wrote it, and yeah, you knew me when I wrote it.
It was for the UNLV thing.
For the UNLV thing.
But it came out like really cool.
Yeah.
Yeah, I liked
it. I was trying to think about that because you sent me a message like, should I write for this gay competition? And I was like, I don't want to write like a gay script. Like, I'm good. And then I was like taking a shower. I'm like, how do you make like a gay LGBTQ script like really cool?
Yeah.
And that's what I came up with.
If you have someone else in mind, but I'd be willing to like, you know.
Go the length.
Yeah. I'll like modify.
You modify?
I'll get a septum piercing.
Oh, that'd be pretty. You'll modify. Oh, okay.
I'll like change like my hair color. I would like if I did that one, I'd like to like really method act.
You're gonna have to be like legit bi though.
Well, no, I thought I read the character is just like straight gay.
Oh, okay, yeah. I
mean, where
kind of are straight.
He's not like really flamboyant, but he's like gay.
Yeah.
So
it's like Mala Noche. Oh yeah.
I know what you mean though.
It would be hard to shoot because I really do want to shoot it when it's like raining almost. And I really want it. I want it to be great, like the clouds and like the sky to be great, because I want the whole thing to like look like concrete.
That's like a really good like palette.
Yeah,
palette. I like that. And it's called Rotten Pavement.
Yeah, Rotten Pavement.
Yeah, I'd like to go, if we do that, like do a lot of stuff with like the costume too. Mm-hmm. Like go to thrift stores and stuff.
Yeah. Oh yeah.
And
that'd be fun.
That's gonna be a fun project to work on in one way or another. Oh, we should make some music for that too.
Yeah, that'd be great.
It'd be cool to have like really some grungy music for that.
I told Kate that idea, and she's like, it's too cheesy.
Too cheesy,
yeah. Yeah. I'm like, whatever, Kate.
Not the way we're going to do it.
Like that?
You know? He told us all about it.
Fucking weird.
Like, next time we hung out, he's like, guys, let me tell you my hemorrhoid story. Yeah, hemorrhoids. That
sucks. It reminds me of the story that Johnny went through in high school. Don't tell anybody this. Johnny was like mostly by himself at this point in high school. And this girl in Speech and Debate was talking to him a lot. And he's like, I really like this girl. Like, he hasn't had a girlfriend or anything by this point. He's like, I really like this girl. I'm like, all right, man. Like, yeah, you should go for it. And one day he's like, he comes home. He's like stupid depressed. So I give him the space a little bit. You know, I approach him when I feel like he's ready. I'm like, what's up? I'm like thinking like, oh, she rejected him or some shit. And he's like, I'm like, what happened? He's like, she told me that she has herpes. like really bad herpes.
Yeah, that's like not fun to hear.
But like,
so he stopped talking to her.
Yeah. But he felt so bad about it. It wasn't like a thing. She was like, I understand. Like, she's like, I'm gonna tell you this because I want to be truthful with you. But like, I have herpes.
Oh, so she liked him too.
She liked him. Yeah. They both liked each other.
And because she had herpes, he like cut her off.
Yeah, he kind of stopped. I think he was just like, he was so. He did, yeah. Basically, like, in terms of the actions he took, he cut her off. But he was, like, so, like, at a lack of words for it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You know?
If you, like, really liked someone...
If I do crash into something, what do you recommend? Like, the dumpster?
No, like, nothing. Like, that's why we're in an empty parking lot.
Okay.
So I have the clutch all the way down, foot on the brake right for now. Feel it. Feel all the different gears. That's second gear, first gear, third gear. That's fourth for sure.
The fuck?
Yeah, and then reverse is like this. You have to really put a lot of effort in reverse. Look at this.
Flash camera.
Camera!
So you feel like right now it's in neutral. Reverse, you put it as much to the side as you can. You wanna run this over? Put it in first, clutch all the way down. Now slowly start.
Oh shit! So to stop, I gotta like go on the clutch and clutch. Go down to first.
Clutch, go down first. There you go. Yep. Ooh, brake. You hit the brakes.
I was on the brake.
You probably weren't on the clutch enough then.
Oh, I could have been.
You have to be deeper. Yeah. Go. Takes muscle memory, and then when you get the muscle memory down, it's pretty fun because then you're just like you're going like you're gas. Wait, there's a car coming.
Actually, there's two cars coming. Actually, there's three cars coming. Wait for that other SUV to pass. Second. There you go. There you go. The gas.
And we're off.
Yeah. We got it. I should put my seatbelt on. Oh, yeah, we're good. All right.
No, it's not annoying. This is cool.
Break. There you go. Now you can put the parking. Now you can turn off the car.
Nice.
Yeah.
Okay, that's cool. Sweet. All right. Thanks, Norby.
Yeah, no problem, man.
There we go. That was cool.
You want to get back in this spot?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah.